Jonesy, can I just tell you, I'm a fan first, right? Like, I
know,
love this team, right? I love this town. I miss the Flyers, man.
Yeah, we do,
too. I miss them.
We recognize what it means to play in this city, no matter what the sport is, to appreciate all the other teams as well, but to make sure you don't lose your spot. And we lost our spot. So we've got a lot of work to do to try to regain, you know, the trust from our fan base, to make sure that they understand that there is no shortcut. There is a responsibility to give the message to your fans on what you're doing. That's probably the biggest driving force behind me even considering to take the job, to make sure that they understand that we're not doing this alone, that we're gonna keep them involved in what we're doing. They want you to show them that you have some life. They want you to appreciate what it is to be here, take it all in, but at the same time, give back to it. We're gonna answer the questions. Those questions will be answered, and eventually we're gonna show what we got.
John Tortorella not on the bench tonight. He's upstairs with interim general manager Danny Briere as he'll get the eye in the sky look. Jonesy, what can he see up here that maybe he doesn't see down on the ice?
Yeah, a lot. There's no question about that. And if you're a player, you better be on high alert because there's nowhere to hide. The coach is staring at you from high above. You can see effort. You can see decision making. And it's going to be a good test for the Flyers here.
In my 28 years in this business, there's nobody that I have covered that's been as gentlemanly. He happened to be a really good player too, as Danny Briere. He's prepared himself for this moment. I'm excited for this. I'm excited to see young eyes, fresh perspective, and everything that goes along with Danny Briere. And we'll see how they assemble the rest of the staff around him. But I think this is an exciting time.
Ready? Yep. Danny looks like a young man. He looks like a young boy to me, but he has a fire about him of trying to get this right. He has some Philly blood in him, played here. I think he's going to be a true leader in how he presents himself. He has a belief in how this should be done. I think it's huge as we start this here.
I would say this, as we embarked on our efforts to recruit a president of hockey and the general manager, we wanted to find the best possible candidates. We feel like we did that with Danny Briere as general manager, and that's why he'll be here for the long haul. In terms of both Keith and Danny, we wanted to find the best person, as I said. It just so happens they both have Flyer pedigree. They know this market really well, but don't make a mistake. They are all about bringing a new era of hockey here to Philadelphia.
Getting the rink alive again.
Yeah, and when you've seen it alive. That we played in it when it's alive.
Fans here in Philadelphia always like the big do-si-do from the Broad Street Bully days.
Jones. There's a big difference, man. Like, it's... We had moments where it was alive this year.
He scores! A beauty for Tippett and his first career hat trick!
You got a little feel for it. It was a little teaser. But
teams and you guys were good.
Yep. Yes, it was. It's a type of environment that you can thrive in. You know, if you're willing to play the right way, you'll enjoy it.
There's nothing like it here.
Well, me. how you doing, buddy? Good to see you. Good to see you, Brian.
Good to see you.
Great to see you too. Not gonna miss this.
Hello, everyone, and welcome into our welcoming day for the Flyers' new leadership as we get a new era underway here in Philadelphia, a new era of orange. I'm Brian Smith from the Flyers Broadcast Network, and joined today by our new leadership. Dan, let's start with you. Tell us a little bit about how things went here over the past few weeks.
Well, first of all, Brian, it's been real exciting for me to become part of Comcast Spectacore and the Flyers family. And as we thought about this search for a new president, a new general manager, we had to keep not only a knowledge of our great history and how important the Flyers are to the city of Philadelphia, but we had to find two leaders that had exemplified not only that tradition, but where hockey is headed in the future. And quite frankly, in Keith and Danny, I think we nailed it.
Al, let's get right to it. This comes as a bit of a surprise to us. Now, were you aware this was something Jonesy might want to pursue?
I was aware something was going on. Then when he went off the grid over the last week, except for the national TV or whatever, wasn't calling back, I thought, oh boy, this could really be serious.
Ready?
Yep, let's do it.
So now that it's official, how does it feel to be the president of the Philadelphia
Flyers? It feels a little bit surreal. I'm just very humbled and proud at the same time. It was a long process, especially with working at the same time. I was happy to have a good night's sleep last night. Look forward to having this team in a position in the future where I can get a lot of good night's sleep, but it's going to be a while. I want our players to love playing here. I want people to know that they love playing here. I know when I flew in here for the first time when I was traded from Colorado, I looked around at the city as I was landing, and I was just so pleased that I was going to play for the Philadelphia Flyers. And that's where we're gonna get this back to. And I really think that's a message that everybody around here needs to be aware of. You do your job well, you're gonna be here. I haven't been in the locker room in a long time. I have not been in this dressing room since I played here. That's 23 years ago. This is a sacred place to be. And I never wanted to step back into it until now, because I'm a member of the Philadelphia Flyers.
You in the playoffs?
I don't know. I have no explanation for it. Things are happening. I grew up watching the Stanley Cup playoffs, and I always dream to be there one day. Whenever I have a chance, I just try to enjoy it.
The last 2 months, I've been acting as if I was gonna be the GM. So it's a cool moment when you're told that it's official and it's your turn. Been bleeding orange for a long time. I'm excited that I have a say in the future and how this team is gonna look. I've had the chance to be around Jonesy quite a bit around some of the alumni stuff that we've been doing. Right away we dove in into our team, what we wanted to do, the kind of the future, the direction we wanted to go in. We have the same vision as far as what we want to do with this team.
He is a terrific human being, number one. He is an incredibly smart hockey man. He chose to play for the Philadelphia Flyers when he was an unrestricted free agent, and he has not left. That means a lot. This is a player that understands this community, this fan base, and knows the game and has a deep respect for the game.
We're both, I think, looking forward to getting down to business and really getting to work.
That's pretty impressive for a first-time GM's first trade.